stories here, buried between the bricks of her brown stone skin. Psalms, stitched into her palms. Diaries, dangling from the arch ladder to heaven she wears as a spine. She is the most beautiful library I have ever seen. I mean, there are poems shoaling down the Lenox Avenue that lines her hips, letters dripping from her lips. A million and one tales of her trails rest in the depths of her dimples. Hear one every time she smiles. She's been here for a while. Traveled from diaspora and slave trade to the big white house at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. All the while filling the pages in her journal, she's an author, but never penning her pain on paper, rather wearing it as an armor. Contrary to what you've heard, yes, you can judge a book by its cover. Feel her. Her pores spit a collage of the bumps and bruises she's collected along the way. Life lessons scripted in braille. I said feel her. Place your hand on her heart and let the thunder of the Harlem Renaissance slip into your fingers. Press your ear to her pulse. Have you ever heard lightning bolts sing? Feel her, but they're more interested in filling up on her. Run undeserving fingers through the thick of her roots and dare to call her a nappy-headed hoe. Caress the small of her back with the stick of their labels. They French kissed her, forgetful. So on most days, she can't say who she is anymore. Mammy, matriarch, or welfare queen. Colored sapphire bold, she's a mad, black, half-woman, half-Jezebel video hoe, superhero, or superhead. Sometimes she doesn't know. A walking chorus of question marks, and I'm not sure. I found her, confined in the space between who I am and who I'm trying to be, and I begged her to bless me with a story that I may tattoo under my tongue and tell my daughter of her glory. She spoke with the scent of essence on her breath and the raspiness of lost time in her throat. Told me that long ago she built a railroad, placed it underground to conceal it, and paved it with bricks of hope, on where slaves used bare feet as tongues to let their souls taste freedom. She beat on my eardrums with tales of her sojourney, how she spit her last name on a pulpit and made them hear it. Mrs. Truth parked the bouquet of roses under the nose of segregation, and the scent sparked the boycott of an entire bus system, and now she sits wherever she wants to sit. Matter of fact, she doesn't even take the bus anymore because she's a self-made millionaire. Developed hair care products for women that look like her, an entrepreneur. So when she walks down the block, they address her as madam. She knows why the cage bird sings and wonders if they've forgotten. Forgotten that she's a queen. Because lately, the closest she feels to royalty is the cover of King magazine. They photo shoot, she's bulletproof. Poses like she's supposed to. A pin-up girl pinned down. Because in her curves lie the incapability of having authority, or so they say. But she tells me that she's been fighting they for as long as history be. And on most days, she finds comfort in the music of her heartbeat. Her victory song is on. Read along to the lyrics on her sleeve. Split by gashes from broken glassy, she's been throwing baracks at the ceiling and will keep going until they respect her like the first lady that she is. She wonders if they know that she swallowed the universe and given birth to the biggest, brightest star, that her sons are sons, breastfed the Milky Way so they hold the world on the tip of their tongue, talk like Martin but as sexy as Malcolm, and hearts that don't beat the Big Bang. She tells me that they are beautiful. I tell her, trust me, I've seen Dwight Howard. I know. And I spent plenty of time in your aisles, picked up book after book and read until my eyes bled ruby. Ruby like the bridges you built over their hates. I have marveled at your stories. And yeah, my name is Sarah, but I'll gladly be Harriet, Sojourner, or Rosa, and I promise to carry myself like a madam, and be Michelle, the queen reinforcing my king, and sing like the bird that Maya told me about, and I will never, ever, ever forget your stories, because you are me, the black woman is me, and I am stunning, y'all. The sun has loved my skin. I hold Mother Earth in my complexion. In my tone lies the thrones of Cleopatra and Nefertiti. I'm the queen Prince Akeem and Semi came looking for. My eyelids open doors to a museum of my struggle. Exhibitions exhibiting that the black woman is beautiful, from fresh perm to afro, high tops to high heels, high yellow to licorice, from fast food on late nights to soul food on Sunday, from Sarah Kazadi to Aaliyah Thomas to Shayna Graham to Nicole Maya, to Desiree Chase, to Lisa Jackson. I could keep going, to my mommy, to my mommy's mommy. She is beauty. Read her stories, the ones buried between the bricks of her brownstone skin. Read the psalms stitched into her palms. Read the diaries dangling from the arch ladder to heaven she wears as a spine. And I dare you to love her longer than February.